sat here very quietly listening to all this BS, quite frankly. And did you listen to anything McMaster said today where he said, I was in the room, that didn't happen, nothing inappropriate was shared? You're basing all these allegations off of one or maybe two sources, which
CNN
reports. Two former officials knowledgeable of the situation confirmed to CNN the main points of the story. Two former officials. Tell you what, come out, name those people, then we'll have something to talk about.
One, we protect sources. Two, it's not just CNN. It's Washington Post, New York Times, Wall Street Journal, CNN, ABC, NBC.
Yeah, but who are the sources?
Carl.
Who are the sources? Oh, because they're hiding behind this in anonymity.
Oh, please.
And that's what we're seeing.
Please, do not even start with me that you're just going to attack sources.
Okay, so
that is ridiculous.
So are you saying McMaster is lying?
I'm not saying McMaster is lying.
Well, he didn't really answer the question.
He didn't answer the question.
He said nothing inappropriate was shared.
No, that's his opinion.
That would be.
But that's his opinion.
You cannot say, you cannot attack, do not attack the stellar reporters of CNN who have their sources and would protect their sources.
The stellar reporters of CNN that I am going to attack right now and say, guess what? I don't believe them because they're staying anonymous. If they are that, if they stand behind this story, come out, face the camera.
Can I just say something?
All I've been doing is facing the camera, Carl.
The people who are in that room?
We have anonymous sources. We protect them for real reasons. So the information that is important to the public
can get
out. So did
Watergate not happen? I mean, those were anonymous sources. Was that not a real story?
I'm saying that there's been so many anonymous sources.
But seriously, so Watergate, just it was all a lie because it was anonymous sources.
It was a trial.
Right.
Carl, you're embarrassing yourself. You're really, you're embarrassing yourself, your party, and your country. You should not be doing this. You're a better person than this. I'm ashamed for you. This is not the discussion we should be having. This is a serious moment in our country's history. The President of the United States has been accused of and has admitted to sharing highly sensitive information to the Russian government.
What?
To not only the Russian government, but to a known Russian spy, Sergei Kislyak.
Let's deal with the facts. H.R. McMaster today confirmed when he was speaking to reporters that that Trump's aides, after the meeting, went to the NSA and the CIA to ask about classification of information that Donald Trump discussed. If there was no problem with what Donald Trump discussed, why was Tom Bossert going to speak to the NSA and the CIA afterward?
Well, since you so nicely pointed out that I do understand classified material, after a lot of these briefings, there are a lot of calls over to NSA, to the DOD, to find out if anything was classified beyond what they talked about. So guess what? These calls happen almost every single time.
H.R. McMaster says, I don't really know why.
So these calls sometimes happen after a lot of these meetings. So guess what? I still don't believe, I think this is a complete witch hunt.